Today, I'm going to show you how to unlock a hidden feature of your NerdKit's LCD screen. While officially we don't include a backlight, I'm going to show you how you can use a little bit of analog circuitry, plus the digital power of the microcontroller, to backlight the LCD you already have included in your USB NerdKit. There are two major types of backlights for LCDs. One is LEDs, which stands for light emitting diode, and the other is EL, which stands for electroluminescent. EL backlights tend to be more efficient and have more uniform lighting than LED ones, but they require some tricky circuitry to drive. If you've heard of organic LED displays, or OLEDs, that's basically an array of electroluminescent strips shrunk down to the size of individual pixels. So far, every kit we've shipped and continue to ship includes an LCD with an electroluminescent backlight. This might change in the future, but for now you're all set. Electroluminescent backlights are actually hard to drive because they require about 100 volts AC at 150 hertz. All we have on board is the 5 volts to power your microcontroller, but we can generate the high voltages using an inductor. An inductor is just a coil that stores energy in the magnetic field, and it tries to keep the current running through it steady. But if we suddenly stop any current from running by opening the switch, the voltage across the inductor will rise very quickly to try to maintain the flow. We can capture that voltage spike using a diode and store it in a capacitor. That's basically how our circuit works. By pulsing the transistor Q1 on the left very quickly, we build up a big voltage across capacitor C1. Then, pulsing transistor Q2 on the right much more slowly, we periodically let this voltage be applied across the electroluminescent panel, or not. Just a quick safety warning. That voltage spike can get very big, and in our circuit, we're talking about a couple hundred volts. Definitely avoid touching it, and protect yourself and your computer. Don't blow out your USB port, and know where the high voltage nodes are, and stay away. And here's a demo of the working circuit. One nice thing about doing this with the microcontroller is that you can actually fully control the brightness in software. Here, I'm changing the frequency that we're driving Q1 using the USB connection to the NerdKit. Now we'll pan over to the LCD while I'm changing the frequency, and you can see that I basically have a nice smooth control of the brightness. So now I'll go turn out the lights. And the backlight feature is really especially useful when it's dark. So hopefully we'll have some videos showing cool applications of this functionality in the coming months. Hopefully that was a fun first taste of analog power electronics. For the source code, schematic, parts list, and more detailed instructions, take a look at our website at www.nerdkits.com. And if you have more ideas for videos like this one, send them in our feedback form.